always fire up our good old friend terminal. So the first thing we'll do is clone, get the latest code of Pigeon. Okay, we'll go ahead, get clone. Actually, let's do it in my desktop. That's bitbucket.org, uarg, and pigeon did git. Let's clone that. So, let's wait for that to update. Please make sure you read through the dependencies. It contains information for the packages that we'll need. But just to let you know, we'll need just Resty, which is the driver for Rest Assured project I built to enable us to have persistent data, or the interface to the DB. Okay. That's done in there. We're going to Pigeon and then source. Now remember, I was telling you we need the driver, and it's included as a submodule, so this is, yeah, this is the kind of command that you will run, or initialize, Resty. Checked out that path, and now we are good to go. And in a sec, you'll see what I mean. Okay, so this is what it looks like when you just open your bare bones, okay? That icon is to enable you to edit the attributes of an image. That's to enable you to add the associated text file just in case it wasn't automatically discovered. That's to delete an image. That's to add extra images. That's to provide a directory to watch. That's to upload to the cloud. Actually, I'll scroll over them, edit current image, add telemetry info, remove current image, add images, select directories to watch. You could select multiple. At any time stuff gets thrown in here, it will appear in, it will be added for your viewing and safety. The cloud, that's to download from the cloud. That's to print current image information. So that comes out in the format of a CSV or KML. That you could integrate into Google Viewing or provide to judges. That's to exit. And then, this is just for information, okay? Current image not in sync, hit control there. As you can see, we failed to connect. Not connected, okay? Now, as you can see, we have all these errors failed. Now, I'll give you a realistic scenario, okay? Images will be coming in from to some, sudden place, okay, some computer, and at any point multiple different people should be able to use the exact resource base. Crap, why did I open up Skype? I'll quit. Okay, so a realistic scenario will be you having will be the server running in a central location and everyone is connecting to it, and for that this is the closest I could get to natural. I'll just SSH into one of my machines. We might even get to run the server up there. And I'll sign in. Okay. Now, let's remember I said we needed Rest Assured for our persistent data. Now, on it, that's the way you'll do it. Okay, that's done. Going to Rest Assured. So the first thing you'll want to do is sync the DB. Once that's in, we'll create users. UARG. Okay. Alright, then the next step will run Rest Assured, make sure the database is accessible from an IP. Let's make it available to any other computer. Now notice this is in a way different machine, okay, where I'm SSH'd into. Run it there, but now I'll check in my Mac's current browser if things are running, okay. Oops. So, go to 192.168.1.108. And just to prove to you that we're running on way different machines. Notice in here. Okay. Notice in here that this IP is 105. I'll stop that. I'll run. Okay. Notice this IP is 108. This guy is 105, right? So I think that should be proof enough that we're running on different machines, right? And then let me continue again with that. And remember the URL. If you run it without a URL, it will ask you which one you want to run on. What one to run it on is GCS, Ground Command Station. GCS, as you can see, there's nothing in here. To be more explicit, we have a marker handler or image handler, okay? And now let us begin the demo, right? So we failed to connect. Let's close it. And I'll show you how to fire it up on the command line with the argument. So if you do dash H, it should provide you with options. So as you can see, that's the IP information, the port. And now eavesdropping mode is to enable you to run the ground station as pretty much like a mirror of everything else that happens. So any change that's present in the on the server should be automatically reflected, okay? Now let's start with Alright, okay. As you can see, no new changes, all right? And now, let's start adding stuff in. Actually, I want to use shortcuts. I'll actually go click, okay? So, right there, add images, hit that. We'll add random images, okay? Now, one thing I told you, remember, these images should be usable by everyone else. Like, someone logged in from a different machine. If you pushed up any changes, they should be able to see them. And to access that, you'll go to Uploader, okay? Now, in Uploader, that will contain all the synced info. So, for example, if you start uploading an image, if you work on an image on your ground station, add information and push up the changes to the cloud, if that file isn't present in the cloud, then it will be put in a central location so that everyone else could view it and that kind of thing, okay? Deletion, however, will be managed by someone else because you don't want to always do a simple delete and the file goes away for everyone, right? Shall we? Let's add a couple of images. I could do the multiple thing. Open them up. Okay. And time to navigate. Okay. Now we have this nice looking water. I think that's a tower or something. Okay. Let's place a marker here. Say antenna. Hit save. Okay. Let's see what image attributes are. As you can see, none of these are in. We'll hit cancel for now. Okay. Once we hit save that. Now you notice the color changed. And during the save, it went automatically extracted. As you can see, the last sync time changed as well automatically. Oh, never extracted that. Well, let's go add in the files. Actually, you know what? We don't have associated text files, so this is a bad example. I'll just take these guys out and grab you content with an actual good text file, okay? And those are from marker recognition. Let's manual a decade. Let's go to Pigeon. Right under our noses right here, we have all this good stuff. Add as many. Really. in the mail. There we go. Okay. As you can see, unsaved file. Alright. Let's hit save. And by the save, you can do Control S or just hit that. Okay. So you the associated info. Remember, it got auto extracted. Altitude. That's that. Phi. Of course, we don't have that. So, you know, all that information. And that's useful in the georeferencing. Okay. We'll move a marker right there saying sample one. Hit save. Great. It is great. Let's save that to the cloud. And notice that every time you edit something, concurrent editing, right? Every time we save, you hit before save, things are kind of bluish. Hit save, goes up. And now let's view current content, okay? GCS/marker handler. Okay. Remember that was the last item that entered, concurrent editing. And just to cut out. Okay, let's just view the comments. We have grade sample one. We populate this one, populated one. Hit save. Let's view right there. Populated one, okay. And by the way, let's sort according to last edit time. There we go. So the latest comes in. In reverse. Concurrent editing. Condition. Create asphalt. All right. Okay. So using the specimens, condition asphalt. Move here isn't saved. Ah, there we go. Unsaved. Right, as you notice that every time I uploaded, hit that and save, great. Okay, here we are. Next, notice that before an image is saved, we have the long path. Okay, and by the way, remember I was telling you about the uploader. So, time we go to uploader here. These are the two files that are present, okay? These one, the JPG65. Remember the old file that we had? Okay, and that's info in it. Now, anytime data is, like I was saying, if you push up a file, if you use a file, we don't have data on it. If we have the data on it or whatever, irrespective, if it doesn't exist on the cloud, a copy of it will be pushed up and viewable by others. Add that, okay. All those are pushed up, and if we hit here, we should be able to see a count of three and a new image that just came in, as you can see, to the JPG. So you should never have to worry about that. Now let's test out directory watching. Okay. I'll go up here. I'll make a directory called Phony. Okay. And in Phony, we'll copy, let's see, data processed, let's copy the first 10. Really? Okay, oops. Oh. Never mind. This is how we'll do it, because LS duh, doesn't give the absolute paths. So data process dash type F. There we go. That should sort it out. Okay, there we go. And LS phony. Here we should have 10 images. There we go. So we're in. Now, I'll quickly just clear up what's in phony. Right? And we'll watch. Hold up. Let me actually close this set. You could have a very good description of what happens when you watch a directory. Okay? Now, we're going to watch phony. Okay, we'll be watching it. So anytime we drop something in there, should expect it to come up right here. As you can see, promises guaranteed. So that's a cool thing. But in real time, like, images will be flying in if at any point they come in, and this allows you to watch like multiple directories if you want. Okay, so we'll add info. I think I like that feature. Now, as you can see, we could add, edit, do all that. Now, deleting of markers requires a combination of concurrently hitting the right and left buttons of the keypad. But I'm using a trackpad right now, and that can be simulated. I could do that off my Ubuntu machine. And now, again, to simulate two people using it, using this thing. Hold it. Simulate two people using this. I'll do a GNOME terminal. Or you know what? Actually, I'll just separate the SSH. Dash I. So this is running off my Ubuntu machine. I'm just I'll be able to view it over the next server. Okay, turn up. There she came out. Okay, well, as you can see, an entirely different feel and look of it. Now I'll show you syncing from the cloud. That's what happens, but I will add something there and also back here. Hit that, save. And if I look at the X server, let's pull stuff from the cloud. As you can see, remember this is running over X, right? So it's kind of slow in running. But as you can see, when I hit sync from the cloud, it pulled in these exact changes. And I'll move. Look at me. I'll move all these into one spot here. So this is to simulate, like, for example, Rajesh and let's say Andrew or Cindy using this in different places. Aloha. Okay, hit save, sync that to the DB. Hello. X is kind of slow. So, when I pull from the cloud, hold it. Okay, see everything is clustered here. Okay, I'll add extra points into this cluster. Save. Come on. There we go. Sync from the DB. Okay. Anyways, all points are here, okay? Now, an interesting utility that you'd like is print current image information, right? That's a KML generator. So as you can see, wrote CSV information on the image, on the markers, and then the KML report. That KML report is the one that you will integrate into. You'll just add it to your Google Earth document, and you'll be able to recreate where targets are, that kind of thing. For the future, we'll be able to stitch up a whole thing. Just assign one session ID, and it will be able to put everything together. Okay. So, remember I showed you. Sure, you couldn't do that for that. Okay. Information. So we've basically stepped through everything, right? Now let's handle deletion. Delete. Okay. Let me kill our X server. I'll just exit here in this X connection. Close that guy. Now, I'll be mirroring that. And to do that, you pass the argument dash E. So this will act like your PowerPoint. Think, for those of you users that make presentations, think of it as your presentation wall. So everything that I add and get saved to the server will be appearing on. It will be able to appear in the sync guy, right? So Pigeon, let's add a couple of files. Kudos, okay? Now, this is a guy that constantly saves, right? Saving. As soon as we push stuff to the cloud, this guy should do the same. So you should see? Nothing good applied there. Could add multiple ones. Just keep adding files and all that. And notice I'm based here, and when I click here, they should be able to appear right here, okay? I will even move here. So, Angstrom. Save that. As you can see, got moved right there. I'll add a couple more here. Okay. Oops. Ugh, it's annoying. Okay. I'll hit save here. Let's see them appear right here. There we go. Right. So, at any point, if you want to stay in sync with everyone, let's try to see how we handle failed connection. As you can see, as soon as we went off, this guy was like, oh, too bad. Now, that's an independent source. This is the guy who needs a lifeline always, right? This is a mirror. And as you can see, the mirror should accurately reflect that we are no longer connected. We failed to connect. This item isn't in sync. Okay? And if I rerun this, if I run this back, in a sec you should now connect instantly. Okay, there we go. Right? And as soon as it came back on, this guy came back to life. Right? Yeah. So far, that's that. So remember, that's to edit the current information of the image, or to even view it, as a matter of fact. This is when it gets passed back by the drone. That's to add the associated telemetry files. That's to delete. That's to add extra images. That's to watch directories, to push up to the cloud, pull from the cloud, print information, exit. This is your status bar. Okay, let's actually move it to the side. That's a status bar. And with that, thank you for tuning in. And being a good citizen, I will clean up after myself. Okay. Delete. Now notice that while that's happening, if I go to GCS/image handler in real time, you know, it's only one image present, right? And when I delete it, it should also reflect here. Okay, back to your state we left. And yeah, again, thank you very much. All the best. Thank you.